everybody. I hope you are well and I hope you've had a fantastic week. I can't believe we're in October already. And let me tell you a little secret. You won't tell anyone though, will you? It's only 11 weeks till Christmas. Now, it's our final week of telling God's story this week. We've loved learning about some really important people in God's story. And now we're going to stop our video again for the final time to say thank you. Now, I've loved doing this each week. I've loved stopping and sitting with my children and thinking about what's gone really well. Now, just because we're stopping doing this in Treehouse, it doesn't mean you have to stop doing this at home. So let's pause the video and give thanks. Can you hear something? Did you hear that? Is there somebody here? It sounds like snoring. Can you see anybody? Can you hear that? What's that noise? I think somebody's in here. Let's go and take a look.
Morning. I've just had the most lovely dream. Oh, I was dreaming about unicorns and polar bears and chocolate. Did you have any dreams last night? What did you dream about? Hi everyone, it's Matt here. It is so good to be doing Treehouse with you all today. And we're going to be carrying on with God's big story, just like Lucy was saying. Now, can you remember what we were talking about in God's big story last week? That's right, we were talking about Jacob. Now, last week we were remembering that Jacob did lots of things wrong, but God still loved him and still blessed him. And one of the blessings God gave Jacob is he gave him loads of children. And the Bible tells us the names of all his sons, all 12 of them. We're going to play a game now. I'm going to say the names of each of Jacob's sons, and then after I say each name, you're going to shout it back to me. Are you ready? Reuben. Simeon. Levi. Judah, Dan, Naphtali. That's a tricky one, isn't it? Let's do it again. Naphtali, Gad, Asher, Issachar, Zebulun, Joseph, and Benjamin. 12 sons is a lot of sons. Jacob had Reuben, Simeon, Levi, Judah, Dan, Naphtali, Gad, Asher, Issachar, Zebulun, Joseph, and Benjamin. Today's story is all about Joseph, the second youngest son. Joseph had some very strange dreams. Do you ever have strange dreams? Do your dreams ever come true? Joseph's dreams did. Let's watch the story now.
God's story, Joseph. So part of God's story is about a guy named Joseph, and it begins like this. Once there was a guy named Joseph who had 10 older brothers and one younger one. When Joe was a boy, he was his dad's favorite. In fact, his dad liked him so much better than his brothers that he gave Joe a special gift to prove it. You can imagine this made his brothers jealous. And Joe only made things worse. He told his brothers about dreams he had where he was ruling over them. Well, this made Joe's brothers furious. One day they were working and saw Joe coming. They said, "Here comes that dreamer." They threw Joe into a dark pit. They might have left him there forever, but they met some men traveling from Egypt and sold Joe to them as a servant instead. They thought that was slightly nicer than leaving him in a pit. Then they went home and told their father Joe had been killed by a wild animal. This broke their dad's heart. Kids, these brothers were really bad news. Selling a sibling is never a good idea. Ever. But the Bible says the Lord was with Joe. When Joe was a servant, he worked for a really important rich guy named Potiphar. And Potiphar liked Joe so much, he put him in charge of the whole house. Joe was happy until one day he was blamed for something he didn't do, and Potiphar sent him straight to jail. Well, God was still with Joe, even in prison. The guard decided he liked Joe so much, he put him in charge of all the other prisoners. Then God gave Joe special knowledge about dreams. When two prisoners had dreams, Joe knew what they meant, so he told them. 2 years later, Egypt's ruler called Pharaoh had a dream, and nobody knew what it meant. But by now, one of the two prisoners Joe had helped was out of jail and working for Pharaoh. He told Pharaoh about Joe, and God helped Joe figure out what Pharaoh's dream meant. But Pharaoh's dream was really more of a nightmare. It meant that everybody in Egypt would have food for 7 years, then be hungry for 7 years. Joe told Pharaoh the only way to survive was to store food during the 7 good years. Well, Pharaoh thought Joe's idea was brilliant. He put him in charge. During the 7 hungry years, nobody could eat without getting food from Joe. He was like a human vending machine. Well, remember how Joe had 11 brothers? Like everybody else, they had to get food from Joe. And when they came, they didn't even recognize their brother. But Joe knew who they were. He secretly tested them to see if they changed. After all, they did throw him in a pit and sell him. Finally, he couldn't hide who he was from his brothers anymore. He told everyone to leave the room because he was about to cry. After sobbing for a few minutes, he told them, "I'm your brother Joseph. I'm the one you sold." The brothers couldn't believe it. They had hurt Joe, but God had taken care of him during the good times and the bad. Even with everything they had done to Joe, he forgave them because he was willing to follow God, even when it was hard. Joe told them, "You planned to harm me, but God planned it for good." And God used Joe to save many lives, including the family that was part of God's special rescue plan. And that's the story of Joseph. So in case you missed it, here's the quick version. Joe was his dad's favorite. His brother sold him. Potiphar put Joe in charge. Joe was sent to jail. The guard put Joe in charge. Pharaoh had a bad dream. Joe told him what it meant. Pharaoh put Joe in charge. Joe's brothers had to come to him for food. Joe forgave them. This was part of God's rescue plan. And that's a part of God's story.
God gave Joseph an amazing gift to understand dreams. And he spoke to Joseph through dreams. And God still wants to talk to us today. How does God talk to us? How might he want to talk to you? Some people God still talks to through dreams. But you know what? God speaks to everyone through Scripture, through the Bible. And when you read the Bible, you can hear God's voice talking to you today. But Joseph also had some really hard times he went through. His brothers were jealous of him, and they did really mean things to him. He ended up in prison. He must have felt really sad and lonely. But God was still there with him the whole time. And God used him to save many, many people. Do you ever feel sad? What makes you feel sad? Do you think God is still there, even when you feel sad? And as we come to finish God's big story, I want you to know that in God's big story, there's another son who's coming. This son would go through hard times. He'd be hated by his brothers too. He'd be arrested for something he didn't do. He'd actually even die. But God would be at work through this man to save many, many people. And who is this man? Well, we keep coming back to this, don't we? This is Jesus. Jesus is right at the center of God's big story. I'm going to pray for us now before we finish. Father God, thank you so much that you are always with us and you always want to talk to us, even when we're going through hard times and even when we're feeling sad. You never leave us. Thank you that you were with Joseph and you used him to save so many people. And thank you, God, for sending Jesus. Thank you that Jesus has died on the cross to save everyone from their sins. And thank you that he's risen again from the dead. We pray you would bless all the boys and girls watching this and their families too, and give them a really good week. Amen! Joseph in the story was given an amazing coat with so many colours on it. And now we're going to play a bit of a game all about colours. Here's how the game works. Some words are going to pop up and all you need to do is say the colour that the word is written in. Sounds easy, right? Why not try it one at a time and see how many you can get right?